Hi, I'm Amy Pennington. This week on Check Please Northwest, where you take us out to your favorite restaurants. Need a good old American omelet? Let's go to Greenlake.
That is not coffee. That was bulging.
Or wake up to some local seafood on Bainbridge Island.
I can't speak highly enough about it.
But maybe pizza with an artistic touch will hit the spot.
Handmade, craft, really good wood-fired pizza.
You can taste it all. Next on Check Please Northwest.
Check Please is made possible by Sky City Restaurant atop the Space Needle, where people have been turning special moments into memories for over 50 years. The people at Sky City encourage you to get out and explore all the fresh ideas and tastes our amazing region has to offer.
It's wonderful food.
One of the centers of the culinary experience of Seattle.
It was great. I don't like coconut, but it's delicious.
I'm Amy Pennington, and welcome to Check Please Northwest, the show where diners from all over the area recommend and review their favorite restaurants. So here's how it works. Every week, we have three guests. Each recommends his or her favorite spot, and the other two go to check them out to see what they think. This week, business owner Kaylee Betts wants to show us a place she says has an awesome vibe, communal tables, and a pizza oven that means serious business. But social media director Matt Longman says exorbitant portions in Greece are a perfect reflection of the counterculture that has been a part of the scene at his pick for decades. And up first, a retired cooking school owner, Judy Keene, has it pretty good at home in her own kitchen. So when she goes out to eat, she looks for something a little beyond. She says hop on a ferry to Bainbridge and sail into Hitchcock.
I didn't want to be seen as a real pricey eatery. I wanted this to be, you know, it's on an island, and I wanted it to be fairly quaint. And it's grown up a little bit as far as that's concerned, because people have driven us to do increasingly precious food. The menu is a derivative of our goal to find new ways to bring food from, you know, the fields and farms and oceans, and take those natural, locally sourced whole foods and make a Northwestern cuisine that's rooted in a European style cooking. We decided when we were building Hitchcock to use as much reclaimed material as possible. Countertops in the bar back behind me and throughout the kitchen, our bowling alley, it was Sunset Lanes. The light here came from the antique store next door. The banquettes that you see here that you would wait on, I reclaimed those from a church. We're all passionate about sharing with you what we do through the plates and through the food and the experience. We just kind of ask people bring a sense of adventure and come to enjoy yourselves.
So Judy, tell us why Hitchcock is your favorite.
Hitchcock's my favorite because Brandon, who is the chef, uses local ingredients that surround the Bainbridge Island area and uses them in a unique, incredible way, producing food that is stuff that I can never make at home. So I love that experience. He did a giant octopus that he grilled and served with a sunchoke and apple. He also did mussels with home-cured bacon. His meatloaf is unbelievable, unlike anything you've ever had. He talks to everybody, and he talks to you between courses, explains what he's done, and although it's not a very big restaurant, there isn't a table he misses.
Matt, what did you get?
I actually got the farro lamb dish, and I can't speak highly enough about it. I thought that it, to get a little high concept for a second, it was almost like spring on a plate. You know, you had this beautiful lamb that was cooked perfectly rare, the earthiness of the farro, the young pea vines give that sort of like greenness.
So when you put your fork into that lamb, did the lamb just fall apart?
Oh, it was gorgeous.
Yeah. Incredible. I always have a hard time making a choice there because everything is so good. So when I do the chef's table, I leave it in his hands.
Yeah.
And I really like that because then I don't feel like I've missed anything.
I had a really great experience. We did a sample of the cheeses, did three cheeses that were great. We did the beef tartare, which my mom, I took her with me, and she's not a fan, and I made her try it, and she loved it.
Oh, so good.
It was nice and lean, a little sweet. It was very good.
We loved the onion mostardo that came with the marrow, because we got the marrow as well. I'm a huge foie fan, so I love the foie and the rosemary cake that came with it. We got the three entrees, the lamb and the fettuccine and the gnocchi. And the fettuccine and the gnocchi, I just wasn't that amazed by. It just, like, the fettuccine seemed to have a pretty delicious but simple tomato sauce. So I wasn't like, oh, there's something brand new and interesting being done here, which I was kind of expecting from, you know, the reputation of Hitchcock.
How was your service experience?
It was great. We had got a couple bottles of wine and some cocktails. I was there with four friends, and so, you know, sort of accommodated us doing all kinds of different things around the menu. We had a couple of dietary restrictions, which was really easy to work around with the service staff. So I was pretty happy with the service.
For us, service was very knowledgeable, not overly friendly to start with, but once we actually sat at the bar, which I love to do.
Yeah,
go sit at the bar,
nice.
Get just multiple courses, small plates at a time. We did cocktails, wine. He ended up really warming up to us and was really great, and it turns out it was the general manager. Really enjoyed our time with him.
Judy, walk us through the interior of Hitchcock. What does it look like in there?
So you walk in, and there are not a lot of tables. There's a small bar, very small bar. Great music playing in the background that doesn't interrupt any conversations. It's very comfortable.
It seems like sort of a Bainbridge Adventure type of place. We took the 720 ferry during sunset, and you could see all four mountains from the ferry on the way over. It was, you know, Baker included. So it was beautiful. But again, you know, in there you have a sense, you know, the soft, like, sort of dark wood,
exactly.
the dim lighting, the pictures of the homesteaders. It made me feel pretty comfortable.
So how was pricing? Did you feel like that was a good value then?
Totally on par with any other fine dining.
I'd have to agree with that. I don't think it's a place that you go every single night
right.
for dinner, but it's a great treat to go there. And if you name your price and wanted the chef to cook for you, you could name your price and have him do something that was maybe a little less expensive.
That was something that really impressed me on the menu.
Yes.
Was there's not a lot of places where you can go and say, you know, I want to have you just make me stuff. I want to do a chef's tasting, but I only want to spend $35 or $45. Usually most places you go and it's like, well, you're going to start at $85. And then if you want the wine pairing, it's going to be another $100.
Right.
And then if you want, you know, the foie course, then it's another $30 on top of that, you know. So I really liked that there was that that flexibility.
How about sweets? Hitchcock was just recently nominated or voted as having some of the best sweets in town, the macaroons.
They are really, really good. They're just creamy on the inside, and they've got the egg white on the outside, and you just bite into them, and they melt in your mouth, and you're scrumptious.
The pastry chef was trained by the chef who originally made macaroons at Lauderay, which is the huge bakery in Paris that makes macaroons.
And he also has a deli that's next door, and he cures his own
the
meats.
The sausage was delicious.
The sausage and his pastrami is to die for. They offer sandwiches and soups, and then takeout. The deli doesn't have a lot of seating area, but I'll tell you, it's worth going to.
All right, Judy, well, Hitchcock was your pick. Sum it up for us.
If you want great local food made creatively, done by a chef that definitely shows his love of food and cooking, it's a place to go.
Matt?
Cosmopolitan culinary art across the water.
Mm-hmm. And Kaylee?
Great little afternoon trip, short ferry ride, delicious food, everything you'd expect from fine dining in the city, and just cute, great little spot.
Excellent. Well, you can try this cute, great little spot yourself, along with the chef's menu, at Hitchcock. 133 Winslow Way East on Bainbridge Island. 206-201-3789. It's open for dinner, and reservations are accepted. Next up, social media director Matt Longman says his pick serves great round-the-clock eats. And if you have time, swing into Beth's Cafe.
Beth's menu is classic American diner. We are a greasy spoon. We don't hide from that title. It's just good old American breakfast. We sell approximately 12,000 eggs a week and also about a ton of hash browns. We make our own country fried steak. We make our own corned beef hash. We bake our own muffins. We do as much as we can in-house to keep it fresh. If you look around the walls here at Beth's, we have drawings from our customers, and it goes from some very artistic, nice drawings to very drunken and not so nice. This gives them something to play with while, until their food arrives. Beth's Cafe is unique in that you really do find a lot of different demographics here. I've seen tables where there's three generations of Beth's customers sitting at one table. It's really pretty cool. Because it's been here so long, everybody knows this, and it's just a gathering place.
Gotta order up.
For people that haven't been to Beth's before, I would tell them to expect a big meal, great atmosphere, and we just try to keep it loose and fun.
So Matt, tell us why Beth's was your choice.
Beth's is an absolute Seattle institution. I mean, growing up here in Seattle, there are so many teenagers that I know that, you know, regardless of where they lived in the Seattle area, East Side, South Seattle, North Seattle, they all congregated in at Beth's Cafe. You know, it's the place, even you go there now and it's still music from the 90s. I mean, they haven't updated anything. It's exactly the same as it was, and that's exactly how it should be. Gigantic plates full of greasy spoon food, available 24 hours a day. Beth's is exactly, it is the paragon of the greasy spoon.
What do they serve at the greasy spoon?
They have the gigantic omelet, you know, either 6 or 12 eggs are the two sizes that you can get. My personal favorite is the East Sider with ham and tomatoes, which is basically a plate of hash browns, you know, the size of your face, at least. Mounded up, and then you've got the toppings right on top, and it pretty much lasts me for breakfast for about 3 days. It's got such a warm, fond place in my heart.
You know, Matt, I'm not surprised you say that, because everyone in that restaurant was 20 or under, standing in line waiting with Red Bulls and talking about how much they had to drink 5 minutes before they got in line.
Yeah.
So I felt like everyone's grandmother sitting there. And we sat right under the speaker, which was blaring right in our ears, playing some headbanging music, which I didn't recognize. I'm sure that's not a surprise.
No.
6 eggs. I just kept thinking, I'm glad I'm not having my cholesterol done tomorrow. And consequently, my husband and I shared 6 eggs. Mm-hmm. I ordered a salad and a side of beans to go with it so that we could taste other things.
So are these just like 6 eggs on a plate?
No, it's an omelet.
Oh, no, it's an omelet that's filled with hash browns that are hardly cooked. But should you want more hash browns, you get endless amount of hash browns. Which, if anyone could eat more hash browns after a 6 egg omelet, is beyond my scope of belief. The most interesting part for me was when there was a man who was walking through, who worked there, screaming, I have a vat of hot grease coming through, and I thought, no kidding.
There's a lot of
no
yelling service.
Way. Yeah.
I did notice a lot of yelling service, but I'm with you in you go there with certain expectations.
Exactly.
And right. If you're looking for a breakfast spot that's cheap, big portions. Pretty much every breakfast entree that you could ask for. I mean, that's kind of the expectation you have to go in with.
Katie, what did you have when you went there?
Well, okay, so I went with a few people and we did some sharing. So we had the 6 egg omelet, and it was the one that had cream cheese, smoked salmon, and green onions. And oh my God, there was half a tub of Philadelphia cream cheese in this thing. It was disgusting,
yeah.
Actually. No, I mean, it was great. The dish was great, but the like when you cut into this thing and it just like bleeds cream cheese and it's warm, so it's like, you know, really oozes out. It was a little intense. The smoked salmon was delicious. I mean, it was great. We had strawberry pancakes. We had the house-made muffins, which was nice that they actually bake them there. They're warm, and that was great. So, yeah, we had a nice little sample.
I think it's a great place if you're hungry at 3:30 in the morning.
It is.
But if you're not hungry at 3:30 in the morning and you're sleeping, I don't know. Yeah. I was a high school counselor for 25 years. Yeah. I thought, oh my God, I'm going to see some of my kids here.
Absolutely. Just like you're saying, like, you know, a quarter of the charm of Beth's, Judy, is that people watching element.
I mean,
you go in there and, oh my God, like, you just get to see all, you know, there's the goths, there's the punks, there's the preppies, like, everybody's there.
Well, some people come with their, like, extended family. Like, the people behind us, they have, like, 10 kids, and they're all shoved in this long booth.
But the service was fabulous. I mean, I have to say that the service was They kept pouring that whatever coffee thing they had. That is not coffee. Was Folgers. Maybe.
Whether you wanted more or not, they still right.
Did you notice that they all called each other meow?
I couldn't hear over the speaker. That was right over my head, so I didn't hear that.
Well, you know, and then, of course, there's the crayons and the paper. But, you know, like...
How have we not mentioned that?
Because the whole place is decorated with incredible artwork that people who've been there.
Some of it's not incredible.
Some of it, definitely, you can tell that whoever's been there has had a lot to drink before they got there.
Talk to me about the neighborhood, Kaylee. Where is it?
It's right along Aurora. I mean, it's kind of got an interesting vibe to it. There are a couple other places that I've been to in that area that you go just to go to that. It's not some place you really like hang out and have a night there and like go to a couple spots. Like Uber Tavern up the street is a great place to get beer.
It's not a place, though, when you're waiting for the table that there are other things to do. You just stand in line and wait for your table.
As a plus, the Duck Island Saloon, you can have Beth's food delivered to you next door.
Oh, interesting.
Good to know.
Indeed.
All right, Beth. Well, Beth's Cafe was your pick. Sum it up for us.
It's a Seattle institution. Every kid that grows up in Seattle... It's everybody's got to understand what Beth's means to the grunge movement and what Seattle means.
That's it.
All right, Judy, how about you?
I would have to say a greasy spoon and grunge movement are perfect words for that.
Kaylee?
It's a place you have to go with certain expectations, and it will meet that, and it's a cool atmosphere. It was great.
You can draw on the walls yourself at Beth's Cafe, 7311 Aurora Avenue North in Seattle, 206-782-5588, open 24 hours a day. Reservations are not required. Up next, business owner Kaylee Betts knows where the ovens are Applewood fired. The tables are shared and the pizza is the star. We are going to Serious Pie.
Get people that think about pizza a lot, take it really seriously, and they want to come here and check it off their list when they come to Seattle. The name is Serious Pie, but the atmosphere is not too serious. We take the food really seriously, and that part's really serious, but dining here should be fun and relaxed. In my opinion, the must-have pizza is the fennel sausage pizza. It's fresh house-made sausage, which we put on the pizza raw in little chunks, so then when the pizza cooks, all the juices from the sausage cook right into the sauce and the cheese, and it's pretty magical. Northwest cuisine is part of me, so inevitably it's Italian food with a Northwest flair. We run the fire with apple wood in our woodstone oven. The fire runs 24 hours a day, all day, all night. We get feedback sometimes from guests that they came in and they weren't so sure about the seating and they didn't like how they were seated next to people, and then by the end of the meal they'd made friends with people sitting next to them. That's kind of the vibe of the restaurant, is casual and fun. A lot of times people wait for a long time for a table here, so it's really important to me that they feel like it was worth the wait.
So Kaylee, tell us why Serious Pie is your serious choice.
Serious Pie for me is, like you said, for Beth's, a Seattle institution. It's a great place to get a feel for the city. It's right in the heart of downtown. I love an open kitchen. The pizza is wonderful. The daily special is always perfect, and it's just kind of a fun atmosphere, and it's a good place to go hang out in the afternoon.
You're a bit of a pizza connoisseur. How is it different from other pizza?
Serious Pie was actually one of the first pizzas that really converted me to kind of, handmade, craft, really good wood-fired pizza. The first time I went there, I felt like it was like almost like a pastry. I love the fluffiness of the dough. It's got a good crispiness to it.
How was your visit to Serious Pie, Matt?
Mine was great. I went for lunch on a Monday. So it was, kind of the beginning of the week. It's definitely a hopping lunch spot. And the appetizers that we had were fantastic. We had this beautiful marinated kale dish that was just crisp and perfectly cooked and it embodied kale really well. And then the dessert that we had was honey cannoli. That was just fantastic. I mean, what an awesome way to finish the meal. I like the... The pie that we had, I think it was potato, pecorino, and an herb of some sort, rosemary. I think it was, yeah. The crust was great, it was nice, crispy. The toppings, I was just kind of like, okay, potato pizza has been done for a while. And I thought it was a nice, clean flavor, but it wasn't something that just exploded in my mouth and, you know, made me rush to the next slice. But again, the appetizers and the desserts were really awesome for me.
We went during happy hour, which gave us a lot of choices. We loved it. We ordered three different pizzas, and every single one of them was wonderful. I love the truffle cheese with the roasted mushrooms, and we had the fennel sausage, and we had the buffalo mozzarella. They're really creative. I know that they did a Brussels sprout pizza. We weren't there when they did that, but the week before. And they just use very fresh ingredients, and I can't say enough about the kale salad. The kale salad was just absolutely delicious. We left there full but not stuffed, happy, with a bill that was not tremendous, good service. For the crust was great, the salads were wonderful, the pizzas were great. We would definitely go again.
The service was relatively non-invasive. We sat down and they weren't really in our face. The waters were refilled regularly. The food came out at appropriate speeds. It really didn't seem to be something that stood out and really interfered or made you remark about how the food was being brought to you. It really allowed you to focus on what was being brought to you rather than.
And how about you, Kaylee?
They keep a good eye on you, and that's great for that room as well. They fit a lot of people into a little bit of space, so they can really keep an eye on you without having to hover or ask too many questions.
Judy, talk to me about the inside of Sirius Pie. What does it look like in there?
You know, it is an incredible, I love the atmosphere, great artwork. And you walk in there, here are these communal tables, and we thought, oh my God, we're going to be sitting at this table and we're going to be, you know, other people are going to sit there, and there's the end of our experience, just the two of us. But you can engage people in conversation, and you still have the right and the ability to have a conversation just between the two of you that doesn't interrupt. We never felt rushed. We never felt like we needed to hurry our dinner or hurry even our conversation and get out, even though there were people waiting. So I appreciated that very much, and I think that had to do with the service staff. Mm-hmm. And I loved watching them make the pizzas while I was eating.
And how about sweets?
Coconut cream pie. Oh. I finally got to try it recently.
Me too.
But I've had the pistachio and rhubarb cannoli, but the coconut cream pie, there was all this hype. Obama came into town, right, and he ordered it, special order
for good reason.
Or whatever. It was great. I don't like coconut, but it's delicious.
And I don't even like pie. I don't even like desserts. But that one is worth buying. Yeah. It is fabulous.
It's hard to stop.
Yeah.
And
really
how about
good.
The neighborhood, Matt?
It feels like you're just right in the heart of Seattle. And to an extent, with Dahlia and Lola right next door, you kind of are in one of the centers of the culinary experience of Seattle.
You can usually find some street parking somewhat nearby, but it's a little trickier down there, depending on the time of day.
How about value, bang for your buck, Kaylee?
Pizzas are usually about one pizza per person, $18 to $20, I would say. I mean, it's a little on the pricier side for depending on what your pizza scale is usually like, but it's what I'm used to paying, and it's worth it to me. So.
How about you, Matt?
I think the value is spot on. Well, you know that it's quality ingredients, you know that it's local, you know that it's not filled with preservatives. If I can be guaranteed of that, I'm happy to pay what they charge.
And I'm telling you, if you ever get to go during happy hour, that is the deal of the century.
All right, Kaylee, well, Sirius Pie was your choice. Sub it up for us.
For me, it's a great place to dine in Seattle. It's quintessential downtown Seattle dining. The daily special, I would suggest to anyone going to eat there. And it's just got a great energetic feel. Desserts, beverages, appetizers, everything's spot on.
Perfect. Matt?
I think that it's a culinary experience.
And Judy?
For me, go there for happy hour and you are going to be absolutely thrilled with the deal that you get, the food that you get, and the service that you get. Can't be missed.
Well, you can try happy hour and the pizza pie for yourself at Sirius Pie, 316 Virginia Street in Seattle, 206-838-7388. Open every day from 11 to 11 p.m. and they also have a location on Westlake Avenue. Reservations are not required. So on this week's show, we featured Hitchcock on Bainbridge Island, Beth's Cafe in Greenlake, and Serious Pie in Seattle. Let's recap what our guests had to say.
First, we stopped in at Hitchcock on Bainbridge Island. Judy says if you want great food made creatively, it's the place to go. Matt says it's culinary art across the water. And Kaylee says it's everything you would expect from fine dining. Next, we visited Beth's Cafe by Greenlake. Matt says it's a Seattle institution. It means something to Seattle. Kaylee says it's a place you have to go with certain expectations, but it has a cool atmosphere. Judy says a greasy spoon. We finish at Serious Pie in Seattle. Kaylee says it is quintessential Seattle dining. Matt says it's a culinary experience. And Judy says you'll be thrilled with the happy hour.
We have had a wonderful time this week. I want to thank my guests, Judy Keene, Matt Longman, and Kaylee Betts. Join us next week for three new guests recommending three of their favorite restaurants right here on Check Please. I'm Amy Pennington, and I will see you then. Cheers. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for sharing all your secret spots. And thanks.
Visit kcts9.org/checkplease for more information and apply to be a guest.
Check Please is made possible by Sky City Restaurant atop the Space Needle, where people have been turning special moments into memories for over 50 years. The people at Sky City encourage you to get out and explore all the fresh ideas and tastes our amazing region has to offer.